What is up, Frill Shocker, the 96 Hedgehog here, with our Week 3 matchup going against Alice here in the New Orleans Sand Slash. You guys can hit that like button down below if you haven't already. Subscribe to join the Frill Shocker crew today because you'd be for real and with the king of the crew. So, looking at this matchup, she did make transactions, which I did not note in the team builder because I kind of post-record all my team builders a week in advance and stuff like that. But Alice, I believe is her name, so my bad. Alice made a transaction of two, actually. She dropped, I think it was one of the mons she had prepped for, Maybe, I don't remember. I don't remember specifically what it was she dropped. But she dropped something for Quagsire, and then also picked up Leiron with her extra points she had left over. And she brought these instead of Hitmonlee, which, honestly, I'm surprised a little bit about, because Hitmonlee could have just checked a lot of things. Knockoff would have been really good for some of my team. And she did not bring in DD. That is really huge, because there's the thing here. DD could have just clicked some buttons versus my team if I wasn't careful. Because DD is one of the very few mods that can actually handle Galarian Corsola because of the fact I can't touch that thing if it starts setting up. Psychic Terrain would have been really deadly for a good amount of my team, so I'm really surprised on that, but she brings pretty much everything else we expected, except the Toucan as well, instead of, what was the other thing? I don't remember exactly the other thing was too, I could be wrong, but I'm a little surprised we're seeing Toucan when I have an electric type here. So, there was that. So, let's just go ahead and get into the battle right here. Wait, music's off, yep. So I got Wormy here, and I really wish I brought that Giga Drain set now. Once I knew she had, and right here, I really wish I had just clicked Drain Punch. Right there, I should have clicked Drain Punch. I'm going to tell you right now, I've made massive misplays in this game. The first misplay was definitely not clicking Drain Punch when I could have, because I could have had a strong chance knocking that thing out or lowering it down to a point where it can't do anything versus my team. It wouldn't be able to. So, that was a misplay right there. Not switching up my set when I knew she had Quagsire, because I felt like the sets for my team still were comfortable, but I should have switched this set to then be special. Special with maybe Dragon Pulse then, because then I would have hit Tyrantrum for super effective damage as well. But I guess if I didn't have it, then I wouldn't have been able to really do too much versus the Leiron then. Because then what I could have done is I kind of kept coiling, but then I revealed Giga Drain, and then basically one two-shot hit him, and then just click Giga Drain, Giga Drain, Giga Drain, Thunderbolt, Thunderbolt, Giga Drain, Thunderbolt, Giga Valve, boom. Stuff like that. So, that was a bit of misplay and prep for this Electros, because now it doesn't do too much to her. So I'm going to click Coil here, and now I'm going to click Drain Punch here, and she is the unaware Quag. But surprisingly, she's not leftovers, and luckily did not get a Skull Burn on me. So I'm going to switch out right into my Alcremie here. It is designed to basically take hits for days. And right here, I'm going to set up my Acid Armor. And I'm just going to set up my Acid Armor again, and she's going to click Iron Head. That does no damage to me. And right here, I start clicking Calm Mind, because there's nothing she can do to stop this. And now this Alcremie kind of, okay. So looking at my set right here, if this Toucan is Spadef bulky like it is a damage roll of 50% to like 59 to 60% to kill. So basically, the only way this Toucan lives is if I get a low roll. She's faster, so that kind of sucked, but I get a low roll. RNG, once again, is affecting me. And just, I just hate RNG, man. I hate damage rolls. But right here, she does make a smart play and goes ahead and sacks off her mom by Brave Birding, which I think was definitely the play right there. She's going to go into her lair on there and picked up a crit. Do the crit ends up mattering? I don't really think it does, to be honest with you guys. I really don't think it does. But in the end, I hate the fact it was a crib. I will admit to this. I would have admit to this. A second, depending on how much investment we did for an attack, because we obviously did 27%. So depending on damage rolls, we have a chance. We would have had a chance to potentially, I'm not saying exactly it would happen, but a potential chance to 2-hit KO this thing. And then once that thing's gone, I click Dragon Kiss versus Quagsire, and Quagsire doesn't beat me. I win versus this team once later on was down, but that crit. And I would have probably put Giga Drain on this set, which now in hindsight makes me feel like I should have, because Giga Drain plus my two other attacks would have been perfect, plus the fact of Acid Armor just would have won me this game. So I'm going to go into my Corsola and I'm going to click Strengths up here. And basically, I am positioned now to win this game with Corsola. As she's going to show off the Hex, so I'm sorry about that. And I go for the Ice Beam, and she actually reveals to be Weakness Policy Drift Blim, which is really cool. She actually reveals to be Timid Nature, and does get, unfortunately, some low rolls right here. If we had disabled that right off the bat, right there, that would have been huge for us right there. So now, as you can see, she hit Smashers. This is major. She is jolly because it could confirm by the end of the game. The maximum amount of damage she does with a jolly non-choice banded or choice a non-banded set versus me is 44%. So in theory, she has to get any form of a high roll to kill me. She either gets a low high roll, a mid high roll, or a max roll to kill me here. If she gets that, the game is over. The game becomes a struggle for me to do. She does not get that. I basically win with Nightmare because I'm going for Strength Staff here. I will basically win this game if she does not get the roll in her favor, which the roll isn't in my favor, mind you. But if the roll is given to her, there is a chance that I could lose this game right now. Because I didn't go more physically defensive, which I probably should have, which was a bit of a misplay in prep right there. Or I have given away some of my spadef and put into my defense and stuff like that. Because then, more than likely, I would have won the game. Would have won the game straight up with my Corsola. But she goes for the head smash, she does land. And she gets the roll, which is very unfortunate. So I'm going to go on my Flygon here. I'm just clicking Earthquake because I know she's going to come in on that thing. And two Earthquakes does take this thing on. Flygon! Being a monster, takes out Quagsire. She's going to go into Inteleon here. She's going to go click Ice Beam here. I'm going to go straight into my Mian Shao here. And I am just clicking Knock Off because it's my safest play to go against her. In theory, clicking maybe Power Punch and then Drain Punch was probably a better play. But she's actually going to reveal to be Choice Scarfed and not Specs. I did live a Specs hit, guaranteed, because she was timid. She had to be timid in this matchup in order to do much against me. But she did reveal his Choice Scarf, and right there was I kind of wish I had clicked Drain Punch. Now, the reason why I didn't click Drain Punch, I had it, this thing had specs, I had to get rid of it so that we stack and come in and be able to live one hit. But she ends up clicking U-Turn as I should have clicked Drain Punch. The reason why I didn't click Drain Punch, because if she went for a Skull Burn, I could have killed easy with Thunder Punch. My gut said to Drain Punch, and just because I don't listen to my gut, gonna say this right now, I'm losing the game. Because now, and from not coiling or from anything like that, she has to land a head smash. I don't know why she didn't go for Dragon Claw right there, it was a little risky. Me not being my Chopple shook a berry, so it ends up being the game that it is. And we will take a 1-2-0 loss versus Alice. And it's upsetting because I really think we had the game won with Corsola at the end there, but she just got that lucky damage roll. I hate losing to RNG, but, I mean, it's RNG. I'm going to try to not get mad and get frustrated over it. But this was a good game. I will say this. This was a really back-and-forth good game. Just a lot of mods were putting in a lot of work for each other, so that's all you can really ask for, but, that's gonna be it for this week 3 matchup. We're 1-2, we still have a chance, we're gonna keep fighting. Until next time, guys, I'm Phil Shocker, nice to talk to you, like, comment, share, subscribe. Till next time, guys, peace.